between the Marquette Golden Eagles and the Villanova Wildcats. And before we go any further, let's check in on our star watch, Dick. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
We have a couple of true point guards running their team tonight, and they're running the show. This will be a treat for any basketball fan.
All right, buckle up, folks. Here we go. Early in the ball game, these two teams trying to set their particular tempo. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. They work the perimeter. Goes up for two. He drains it. Strong with a ball and strong with a finish.
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. It's a great concentration to finish strong.
Cross court. The turn, a fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, you gotta be exceptional to make that shot. Because a lot of coaches don't like it because you're going away, you're not in rebound position. You better make it count.
Goes up with it. And score it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
So much for court awareness. He dribbled out of bounds. Trying to smother the inbounder. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. He's all alone. Nails the J. Brunson receives the ball. And come up short. Knocks it down.
Look at that spacing.
For two. Makes the shot.
Well, you know, basketball was like nutrition, Dick. His game would be broken down into the two major food groups, and that's passing and score.
When you combine those two skills, the floor looks a lot wider for everyone on your team.
Goes up with it. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, they'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
Missed it. The small forward with the ball. He shoots the jumper. They get it to go.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. From the corner, the missed shot. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Nails the sweet jumper. Working it around the perimeter. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up for the bucket. He hits the shot. Gets the rejection.
Off the mark with that shot.
Up and inside.
Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick and roll situation.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
Erin Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. Off the mark. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Gave it up. In the lane. They got it. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the J. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
He tries the jumper. Busts the jumper. He pulls up with a jumper. Scores it. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They'll work it around the arc. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Sideline inbounds. Kicks it out. Ten seconds. With the big shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Out of bounds and a change of possession. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
They're working around the perimeter. He tries the three ball. Can't connect. On the left side. And the ball is saved. Great job. And here's a snapshot of how they fare in their conference.
I don't know a coach who doesn't want to be at the top of this list. Conference play is really important, especially towards the end of the season.
Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. They're set to inbounds from the baseline. Moving it around the perimeter. He tries to knock down the three. Missed the jumper. Tickles a twine.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Three. Gets the J to fall. Up for two. Off the glass and no good. You betcha.
Brunson handles the pass. Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper. Who wants it? And he saves it. For two. Buried it. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. He buries it. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. He goes for three. Bust the J. Turnover by the freshman. Fast break possibility coming. Tries for two. Can't put it down. Gave it up. Turnover committed by the freshman. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
On the inside. For two, he shows the sweet touch. Now they work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. That one's off. And a momentary look from three-point land. He attempts the jump shot. Missed it. Tries for two. Nice shot. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the dribble, gives it up. About 6 minutes remaining. He just threw it out of bounds. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Dick.
Hey, you know he's been excellent, Brad. He's been efficient. He's been focused. What a gutty performance. And giving his team a great chance to win.
Blocks the shot. On the wing with a jumper. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
He shoots from the corner. He drains the bucket. For two, comes up short. For the bucket, he drains the shot. Gave it up. He goes up with it. The missed shot. Balanced teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
Brad, they like to balance the attack. They don't feel like they can always play up tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
And come up short. On the dribble, gives it up. He pump fakes. He shoots the jumper. They get it to go. gave it up. Puts up the J. Off the mark. Out on the wing. Four minutes left on the game clock. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He shoots from right of the circle. And score it. Number 25 takes the feed. Scores it. Number 4 handles the feed. Jumper. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Nope. We're at the 3-minute mark. Looking for a good shot. And the block. Howard handles the pass. On the outside. He tries the three. Ain't no stopping him right now from the arc, Dick.
You better believe it, baby. They're making him pay from out there.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Pushes it up. Pull up jumper, left side. Nails a sweet jumper. We're at the 2-minute mark. Down inside. Jumper. They got it. Goes up with a shot. He hits the tough shot.
I'll tell you, he's knocking him down with ease, Brad.
Number 25 takes the feed. Inside. He puts up the J. Missed it. On the dribble, gives it up. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turnaround fadeaway. We're at the 1-minute mark. Number 30 takes the feed. They come with a double team to stop it. Tries for two. Got it. On the outside. There's a double team waiting there.
Oh, what a high rise. A great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
They work the perimeter. Swatted away. Change of possession. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
He bombs from outside. At halftime, The Wildcats trail by 9. Villanova is losing in the battle on the boards in the first half, Dick.
Yeah, the opposing team was clearly more committed to rebound than to rock.
And here's a look at what each team here today will be focusing on when we get things underway.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Number 2 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Looks like they're going to go with a full-court man-to-man press, Dick. The power forward handles the feed, trying to pack it inside. Takes his jumper, missed the jumper. On the left side, the crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home-court advantage?
With the J. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Launches the three. Busts the jumper.
Look at that spacing.
For 2, he gets the bucket. Away, scorches the net with a J. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
Off the glass and no good.
Shooter spotting up on a 3.
Gave it up. For the bucket. Off target. They get that rejected. On the left side. Tries for 2. Goes.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that. Bad decision there by the freshman.
Pushes it up. Goes up for 2. He nails the shot. Brunson handles the pass. Can't connect. Pushes it up. Three-point land. The Golden Eagles have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding them the ball. It's simple.
On the right side. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow-through. Jumper won't go. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
The small forward receives the pass. And now the fadeaway jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
He tries the jumper. The Golden Eagles have got to continue to get him the ball.
Braddy's on fire.
Goes up with it. The Wildcats have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Cross court. return a fadeaway jumper.
I'll tell you, you got to be exceptional to make that shot. Because a lot of coaches don't like it because you're going away. You're not in rebound position. You better make it count.
Off the mark. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. For two. Off the glass and no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Throws it up for the bucket. The small forward gets the ball. He pulls up with a jumper. Knocks it down. Puts up the jumper. The missed shot. Working it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
In the post. Tries for two. No good. The student body is rocking tonight.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
Fast break opportunity here. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Number five takes the pass.
Up and inside.
Number 25 is called for the foul. First team foul. It's been a great team effort for these guys tonight, Dick.
You know, everyone's been getting involved. Passing, rebounding, taking the ball through the hoop. A great team effort will always keep a team in it.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Hey, I'll tell you, juniors and seniors are valuable pieces in any college basketball puzzle. Having experienced kids like this on the court and on the bench can take a lot of pressure off the coaching staff.
Around the arc with the jumper, they get it to go. They work it around the perimeter. Jumper, missed the jumper for two, gets it to fall. It in, takes the jumper, busts the J. Moving it around the perimeter. Looks at a three, busts the jumper. The Wildcats got some good ball reversal there.
You know, Brad, when you move the ball like that, defenses get off balance and out of position.
The small forward takes the pass. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Goes up with a shot. Missed it. Howard handles the feed.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
for three. Nails the jumper. Fed the low block. Baseline jumper. Jumper won't go. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He misses the J.
There's the trap.
He wants a three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Nice penetrating kick there.
Hey, if you're a shooter on the perimeter and there is a drive to the hoop, you need to make yourself visible. Set your feet and give the ball handler a target. Then all that's left to do is knock it down.
Number 25 is fired up right now emotionally.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros. Down inside, nobody rotated down from up on top.
About 7 minutes remaining. We're going to move it around the perimeter. Goes up. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
You know, seniors are important because they bring so much to the team. Leadership, motivation, and a sense of accountability. It's their last year, so you know they want to make it a memorable one.
Second one is no good. Out on the wing. He attempts to dribble around the trap. Unsuccessful, though.
Great job of containing the man there, Brad. Excellent jump shot right there.
Gave it up. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. He shoots from the deep corner. Off the mark. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
He goes up with it. They got it. Bucket. Rims out. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. He can't get the hoop to fall. Looking for a good shot. With a rejection on the dribble, gives it up. He shoots the jumper. Bust the J. Number two is whistled for the foul. How about this display of shooting from deep, Dick?
Hey, shooting like this from the three will definitely open up things on the inside. The defense is going to have to come out now, which is great for the offensive attack.
He'll visit the charity stripe. Misses the first. Second shot.
the perimeter. He attempts the three. The Golden Eagles have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Braddy's on fire.
Trying to feed the low block. Nice rejection. Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job with his footwork to create the drop step.
Four minutes left on the game clock. Steal. Pushing in transition.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Gave it up. With a deep shot from outside. Off the mark. On the right side. A momentary look from three-point land. He gets the board. He shoots the jumper and come up short. Out on the wing. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He misses the jumper. Looking for a good shot. Puts it on the floor and up and under. The missed shot. Brunson receives the pass. On the outside. He gets that one to fall. The partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Locks it. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. Let's go back and take another look at this one, Dick.
Hey, when you can finish above the rim, you've got nothing to worry about, my friend. You should always throw it down if you have the chance.
They're working around the perimeter. Let's it fly. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
For the bucket, with the layup. On the dribble, gives it up. Drains it. The small forward takes the pass. He puts up the J off the backboard. On the outside. He goes up with it. They get it to go. About a minute remaining. He shoots the runner. He gets the bucket.
We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. They work the perimeter. For two. Nope. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Based on the score and the time remaining, the coaches will be looking to calm their players down. Adrenaline levels may have shot up over the last few possession, guys, so the coach will be looking to reduce any anxiety. It should make for an interesting finish. Back up to you.
Well, then, they've had a chance to talk it over. What do you think the players are thinking about right now?
Hopefully, they're thinking what they're going to do to win this game, baby. But seriously, they need to be thinking about their defensive assignments and what their coach wants them to do offensively.
to the live action we go. On the right side. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He unloads. He misses the fadeaway. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? That one deserves another look.
That's a strong take. A strong, strong take to the goal.
Wow, man, that stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Unlucky break, and he fouls out.
Great hustle.
And the clock stopped with a foul. With the freebie. He makes the front end of the one and one. Second one, no good.
Give yourself a chance with a score here.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Gave it up. He shoots from the deep corner.
Better foul quick.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Opportunity now for an easy one. Hits that one. Second one is good. Action's ready to start again.
Look at that spacing.
unloads a three. Rims out. Wow, and that stops the clock again. He goes to the line for the first time. Sinks it. They're seeing him all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Second shot is good. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
We're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. On the left side, with the big shot, misses from three. Villanova fought the good fight, but they still come up short.
This is the type of game that the coaching staff will be studying for weeks to come.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.